So she's sort of the cause, but she's also the remedy.
Natalie Goodpasture sometimes jokes that her best friend may have brought illness into her life.
I adopted her.
Goodpasture's dog, Sadie, often came home with ticks that Natalie would remove.
I never noticed a tick bite.
9 years ago, Goodpasture says she was working as an economist in the Boston area. She says when her health took a sharp decline, she visited dozens of doctors before one finally diagnosed her with chronic Lyme disease, the result of a tick bite.
I have not left my home in over 3 years. The fact that I'm sitting up this tall is a miracle.
Natalie requires 24-hour care, and she's fed with a bottle. She holds a PhD in economics, and she says a switch from conventional medicine to herbal care is helping her battle this insect-borne illness.
I was unable to speak, feed myself, take myself to the bathroom, bathe, dress myself, anything. I'm starting to slowly feel like things are coming back.
Infectious disease specialists say Lyme disease isn't common to the Kansas City area, but cases of Rocky Mountain spotted fever and West Nile virus, both of which originate from tick bites, can be found here.
You can get pretty severely ill.
Dr. Dana Hawkinson with the University of Kansas Hospital says sometimes symptoms of a tick bite don't show up for a few days, and when they do, patients need care.
Things such as just malaise, which is feeling bad, maybe fevers, chills, maybe muscle aches or joint aches. So there can be general symptoms that can be present in any of these symptoms.